This is going to be a video for the beginners. Today, I will show you how to set up your audio interface and record with popular DAW like Pro Tools, Logic Pro X, and Ableton Live. Here's the list that you need before recording. First, PC with DAW. Today, I'm going to be using my MacBook Pro 2012 mid. I don't think there are PCs out there that cannot record these days. Second, of course, the audio interface. If you haven't chosen which one you need to buy, I made a video about buying guides of an audio interface. So don't forget to check out the link. Third, cables. You need at least one XLR cable to connect between a mic and an audio interface. And TS or a quarter inch unbalanced cable for an instrument like a guitar. And you need USB 2.0, USB 3.0, Thunderbolt, firewire, or network cable to connect between your PC and your audio interface. Depends on the connectivity on both of them. Fourth, monitors. You need an earbud or a headphone to listen while you are recording it. Last but not least, you need to install drivers, depends on the manufacturer. Some do not require to install. Let's set this up. Turn on your PC and audio interface and connect them via USB 2.0 or anything that supports both. I run two OS on a MacBook. For the recording, I used the old OS Mavericks. Here is also old audio interface, DZ002 rack. I connect both through a firewire 400 to 800 cable. I need driver to use this unit. You can check out your audio interface support page. You just need to download it and install this on your OS. The audio interface should be recognized in your OS. Go to your preference and check the sound and set the output to your audio interface. Then you can monitor anything through your audio interface. Okay, this is time to set preferences for your DAW. For Pro Tools, go to Setup and Playback Engine and check your audio interface. Before I record, I need to set buffer size. This affects the latency for monitoring and the processing power for mixing. For recording, I set this lowest as possible so I can monitor in low latency. So I set to 32 samples. If you record with many tracks or virtual instruments, you may go higher than this because DAW can stop while you are recording because lack of CPU power and speed of your hard disk. Let's make a session. Go to File and click New Session or Command N. I strongly recommend you to set the bitrate and sample rate before making a new session or project. By the way, for Pro Tools user, you must set this before launch a new session because there is no way around. I usually set audio file types to WAV so that I can share with other DAWs. For music production, 24-bit is standard and choosing sample rate is up to you. I will go with 24-bit 48 kHz this time and type the name of the session. Hello! For Logic Pro X, go to Preferences under Logic Pro X and click Audio. Change output and input device to yours. I set 32 samples for I/O buffer size. Of course, check 24-bit recording. Next, click General and set to WAV for recording file types. Now, make a new project. Also, you can make an audio track. Go to Project Settings under File and click Audio. Set the sample rate depends on your direction. For Ableton Live, go to Preferences under Live and click Audio. Click Audio Input and Output Devices. Set in-out sample rate and buffer size and hit Apply. Interestingly, in Ableton, you can fully change the buffer size. And go to Record. Now, as you know, file type should be WAV and bit depth is 24. Here are a U87 larger diaphragm condenser mic and an XLR cable. You need to use the female connector of the cable to connect the mic and use metal connector to connect your audio interface. If you use condenser mic like mine, you need to turn on phantom power or 48 volt. This should be on front or back panel of your audio interface. If we use a dynamic mic or a ribbon mic, you must turn off the phantom power, especially for ribbon mics. Now, this is the fun part. Let's make audio track in DAW. For Pro Tools, make a new track, double-click the track name and change it. Set the input that you want to use. I will go with mic line 1. Engage a recording button on the track and adjust the preamp gain on your audio interface. A level meter in most DAW is dBFS, which is dB full scale. This 0 dBFS is the highest signal level achievable in digital audio. So, do not go over 0 dB. It will clip everything and distort the audio. Hit the recording button on the top. When you are ready, click play. Yes, now you are recording it. For Logic Pro X, check the input. This time, I will go with input 5. Double-click the track name and change it. Engage the recording and input monitoring button and click the recording button on top. Now you are clear to go. For Ableton Live, click IO on far right. I set input 5 for this audio track and set to auto for monitor. Engage the recording button on the track and hit the recording button on top. How easy is that? No. If you liked this tutorial, then hit the like and subscribe button, and I will see you in the next one. 안녕!